Welcome to Module 1 of the What Works Clearinghouse WWC Group Design Standards Training. This module focuses on studies eligible for review using Group Design Standards. On the slides, some words are underlined and in bold. Definitions for these terms are in the glossary, which is available on the WWC website, whatworks.ed.gov. To receive a certificate of completion for viewing these training modules, you must view the videos on the WWC's website. If you haven't already done so, please view the introduction video before viewing this module. The introduction reviews important background information about this training and describes accompanying resources. You can access all of the resources mentioned in this module through the WWC's website, whatworks.ed.gov. The WWC has standards for several research designs. In this module, we're going to talk about research designs that we can review using the WWC Group Design Standards, namely randomized controlled trials, or RCTs, and quasi-experimental designs, QEDs. To understand the WWC Group Design Standards, we'll need to talk about what counts as an eligible randomized controlled trial, as in a well-executed randomization, and as an eligible quasi-experimental design study. Group design studies measure the effectiveness of an intervention by comparing outcomes for study units, which might be students, teachers, or schools, between two or more groups. Units in at least one group must receive the intervention, which is the programs, policies, products, and practices that is the focus of the WWC's review. The intervention might be a math curriculum, an after-school program, the use of educational software, or an instructional practice for teaching reading. In addition to an intervention group, the study must also include at least one comparison group that did not implement the intervention. The WWC uses a set of standards to evaluate education research studies and assign them one of three ratings. The highest rating a group design study can receive is meets WWC group design standards without reservations. A study can also meet WWC group design standards with reservations. Finally, some studies do not meet WWC group design standards. The design of the study, how the intervention and comparison groups are determined, is a key consideration for the WWC when reviewing studies. There are two designs that are eligible for review under the WWC group design standards, RCTs and QEDs. The WWC group design standards evaluate studies using the framework illustrated here. This module discusses the first point in the framework, the question in the study design box, the design of the study, and whether it used a valid randomization process to form the intervention and comparison groups. Only RCTs with valid randomization can receive the highest study rating. Next in this module, we'll talk about what the WWC considers to be a valid random process. Later modules will discuss the other components included in this framework.